Hello there, and welcome to another Darlings and Duds video. If you've not seen one of these before, it's where I share with you the products that I have been testing out and let you know if they fall into a darling or dud category, or if they're just straight down the middle and they're just plain mediocre. So in today's video, I am once again combining 2 months worth of products. And so therefore, we need to get this show on the road. All right, and as we get started, I will share with you what products I have on my face today because I tried to incorporate as many of these products as I could in my makeup look for today. So starting off with the eyes, I used the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in Eden. I had this a couple of years ago and decluttered it because I felt like the formula changed. And so recently picked this up when Ulta had a sale, and I really, really have been enjoying this. It has a somewhat sheer base, but it still does add a little bit of coverage to the lid. The formula is much thinner than I recall it being in the past. Could have been because the formula in my dupe was a little old when I threw it away, but I've really been enjoying just the little bit of coverage this gives on the eyelid. And then of course, it also helps pop the eyeshadows. Next up is another one of these dazzle sticks from Kat Von D, and I purchased one of these a couple months ago in kind of a reddish, coppery reddish shade, and this shade right here is what's it called? Hail Surge. Oh my goodness. My best friend recently finally picked this up after eyeing it and seeing mine and going, well, should I, shouldn't I? And she loves it as well. So you can see it's kind of more of a sheer base. There is a lot of glitter and sparkle in this, but personally, that's what I love. You can build it up, but my favorite way to use this is to kind of put it on a little bit sheerly and then put a lighter shimmery shade over the top of it, and it really makes that eyeshadow pop. I also sometimes will use this a little bit on my finger and tap it on top of my eyeshadow look as a finishing touch. Great. And this stays put all day and just super impressed. No glitter fallout. It's kind of the way I like to do glitter. Now, speaking of glitter, the other topper that I purchased in another color is one of these Hourglass Scattered Light Glitter eyeshadows, and I purchased the shade Reflect. I am wearing this on the inner kind of half of my lid today over the top of another eyeshadow, and I am loving this. I'm just putting this on top of just about every eyeshadow look, and I just think it brings that look all together. This is a slightly peachy champagne color, but then it has kind of silver sparkle in it, so it doesn't go to gold, but it also doesn't really change too much the color of what you're putting it over. But it is, again, a smooth formula. You don't get that glitter fallout. You do apply it with your finger. That's how I feel like it applies best. But again, another darling in my book. Now, lest you think all is wine and roses in this corner, I have two duds. These guys. All right, what are these? These are by Danessa Myricks, and I actually tested out several of her products when I saw Sephora bring in her whole line of products. I was really interested because she has some really unique ideas. And so these I was immediately drawn to. These are Color Fix, and this is matte liquid pigment, and then this is matte liquid pigment, but this is like the metal color. So this one has a lot of shimmer, and this one is a matte color. Now these are meant to be multitasking. You can use them on the eyes, cheeks, or lips. So that was where I thought, oh my goodness, this could be amazing. All right, so the two shades are Desert Rose and Ballerina. And when I swatched these on the back of my hand after getting them home, I thought, oh, these are gonna be awesome. Well, I tried these on the eyes, I tried them on the cheeks, and I tried them on the lips. So we'll start with the eyes since that's the category we're in. I didn't find them too difficult to blend out. This one is a pretty deep shade, and they are pretty liquidy. So I just went in with a small amount, blended it out, built it up enough, I thought, in the crease, and then I brought it all over the lid. So then I went over the top of it with this because I thought, well, I'd like to see how these layer. And once I put this over the top of this, it was almost like all of the shimmer just disappeared. It was kind of weird. So then I used this separately on another day, just on my lid by itself. And there was just no, you didn't even get that pink backing. Like the base color was pretty much non-existent on the eyes. So I just had a little bit of some shimmer. But again, when I put it over the top of a shadow, that shimmer kind of disappeared. The other thing was on the eyes, I was hoping to be able to wear these without topping them with powder. I got them on, kept waiting for them to dry, and they remained tacky on my eyes. So I ended up having to put powder over them. I thought, well, let's try them on the cheeks. On the cheeks, this is a pretty color, but I felt like it disturbed my foundation as I was trying to kind of blend it in. Thought, okay, last attempt, let's try them on the lips. On the lips, I just wasn't thinking clearly, and they dry down like a liquid matte lipstick dries down. And I found them to be very drying. So unlike on the eyelids where they stayed a little bit tacky, on the lips, they dried down pretty well, but I really felt like they made the lips look really, I mean, emphasize the lines on my lips. So for me, these are both duds, and I just feel like the formulation, it just did not work at all for me. All right, let's stay in with the eyeshadows. Now, I did pick up several eyeshadow palettes. I know that's a shock to you all. Let's start off with this one, the Too Faced Let's Play. These came out, I think, around the end of last year, and I had been eyeing them, but kind of had heard mixed reviews, wasn't sure. And then I saw this one in the store, and I thought, okay, those are my kind of colors. I think there is a complete eye look in here. Let's get it. And I have to say, I have really loved this. I'll pop on the screen some swatches. I've found all of these shades to be very pigmented. The matte's blendable. The only thing I don't like, each one of these palettes has a different scent. And this one's supposed to smell like bubblegum, and it smells like awful perfume. And you know, I'm very sensitive. So you do have to get your nose kind of right up next to the shadow to smell it. So it doesn't give me a headache, and I find it dissipates right away. But that was the only disappointment. But otherwise, cute packaging, love the shades. Next up is this gorgeous palette my best friend brought to me when she helped me pack for our move. And this is by Makeup Revolution. And oh my goodness. I mean, first of all, the packaging, when I opened it, I'm like, wow, it's just stunning. And then I opened it up and I was like, wow, where have these shadows been? This is the palette that I am wearing on my eyes today. I have been so impressed. And when I went on Ulta's website, these don't get high reviews, and I have no idea why. There's two mattes and two shimmers, and to me, this is what I wished Charlotte Tilbury's Pillow Talk Luxury Quad would have been, because this shade is just deep enough to provide some really good depth. These are very blendable. And then this shade can really be built up to a good crease color. This is the shade that I have on under that Hourglass Scattered Light on this half of the lid. And then this one is just a really fun kind of coppery gold shade. So a real warm gold shade. And these two shimmers, the formulation, when you put your finger in them, it is just so smooth and buttery. You don't have to work hard to build them up. I've used them wet, dry, super impressed. Now these next three palettes, I have done separate videos of full review with swatches and everything. So I'm just gonna briefly show them to you here, but I will link those video reviews down in the description box below, along with all these products. So you can check out the review and see swatches and all of that. But the first one is the Natasha Denona Love palette. I'll let you know, this is a darling. The next one is the Pat McGrath Divine Rose Luxe Quad. I think that's, yes, that's what it's called. Beautiful shades, but you should check out my review video. You might be surprised, it's not a darling. And the third one is the Urban Decay Naked Wild West palette. This is one I thought was definitely gonna be a dud for me. and I've actually found it to be a darling. So again, check out those three review videos if you're interested in swatches and my full take on the formula and everything. Now the final palette I have actually not yet talked about. I've not even done a tutorial on yet. And it is the Tartlet Juicy Palette. Oh my goodness, this came out I think in January when I was on my no buy January. I couldn't wait to get my hands on it. And I have really enjoyed this. Okay, so first of all, there are 20 shades in here. A ton of different options. But I have to say, when I first got it and opened it up, I was a little surprised at how overall neutral this palette was, because when I got the little juicy palette, this has much more purple tones and even more pink. I'll show you that one in a moment. And so really, I mean, if you take out that top row, it's a very neutral palette. Now that being said, they are all fantastic quality. The mattes blend well. The shimmers are actually that very gentle shimmer formula. It's not that they're not pigmented, but you get shine, but I don't find that they emphasize texture. So if you're somebody who likes a little gentle pearl shimmer on your lids, but don't want all out glitter metallic, you might really enjoy the shimmers in this palette. But overall, as I said, it is a very neutral palette with just a little bit of some hints of rose and pink sprinkled in. Now, if you purchased at Christmas time, or you're interested in still purchasing, because I did see them available on the Tarte website still, if you purchased this Give Get Gift set of eyeshadows, I reviewed these, which I will link also down below and up above. If you purchased this set, I don't think you need the Juicy palette, because I think the combination of those three palettes, especially these two palettes, I think you've got what you need. And as you see this palette here, you can see what I'm talking about. There are a lot more purple tones, purple mattes, which are missing in the Juicy palette. So the Juicy palette still gets a darling stamp for me, but if you're somebody who is looking for more purple and pink shades like I was, I would go with the Lil Juicy, because this one is just gonna give you a couple of hints of pink and then overall more browns and neutrals. So great palette. Let me know if you want to see some tutorials with this palette. I'd be happy to do that. All right, one more dud and one more darling for the eyes. The dud is this Tattoo Studio by Maybelline. This is one of those eyebrow pins that has the three prongs that's supposed to just help you make it look like you've got hair strokes, make it super easy. I found this thing to be the hardest thing to work with. I had a really difficult time kind of building up color. I didn't feel like it stayed well. Yeah, not a fan. However, a darling is this Lancôme Idôle Mascara. This is a new release over the last couple of months from Lancôme, and this really is a great mascara. Now, I just have the sample size. I have not purchased the full size. So here's what I would say. If you are somebody who struggles to get and keep curl in your lashes, if you're somebody who really likes more defined lashes and length to your lashes, and you have trouble with mascara smudging and flaking, this is a fantastic mascara for you. I personally don't find that I get enough volume with just this alone. I do like to pair it with the Lancôme Cils Booster Primer Mascara, but I will wear this when I'm going for a more natural lash look, or I have loved it on my lower lash line because, again, I don't get any smudging or flaking with this mascara. All right, now one shout out to a nail product. I was going to paint my nails in this color for this video, but I've had my nails painted in this color over the last several videos, so I thought you all might be a little tired of seeing it. It is this nail polish by Olive & June. I didn't know anything about this polish brand, saw it in Target and picked up this shade. It's called AW, and it's a really pretty kind of lavender gray shade. Now, the way I have been personally been loving it is to top it with the Zoya Luxe nail polish. This is my absolute favorite topper. I've had this for about 2 years, but that is my favorite way. But I found it to be actually relatively long wearing, easy to apply, great polish, definitely a darling. All right, now let's move into some lip products. So I really don't have that many to share. Again, the majority of this video seem to be more face focused. So in our lip category, two duds. Let's just get these right out of the way. These came in a recent BoxyCharm. I think it was the March BoxyCharm. And these are by St. Luxe. And you might be thinking, well, Shirley, it looks like you've used up half of one of those already. How is it a dud? Well, I'll tell you, because my very first use of this pencil, the tip broke off. And I proceeded to sharpen and sharpen and sharpen, and it kept literally crumbling and breaking off. And it took me until this point to get it to kind of be smooth enough to apply again. The color was not bad. What shades do I have? Secret Admirer and Love Letter. And the color of this one, Secret Admirer, I thought, oh, this is a great color. But also, and I'm sure it's probably just because it's kind of dried out, but it's a little stiff applying on the lips. So unfortunately, both of these are just duds for me. Now the lip liner that I'm wearing now, which is a super, super high darling in my opinion, is the new one by Natasha Denona. This is I Need a Nude Lip Crayon. This is the shade Julia. And she came out with a whole line of nude lip liners and nude lipsticks. And so according to your skin tone, the depth of your color, you can find kind of what might be your perfect nude color, your perfect your lips but better color. So sometimes I abide by that. Sometimes I just go for tones and colors that I enjoy. So this shade Julia, I love. It's what I'm wearing here paired with one of her lipsticks, and you saw it in my recent video with the Mini Love palette, and I just love it. Super long wearing, very creamy, highly recommend. Now this month, they also picked up another shade of the lipstick. These are the Rearview Mirror Lip Lacquers. I don't know, they have a very long name. Now this shade is Drive My Mauve. You can see it there. It is a little brighter than what I typically go for. So usually I end up toning it down maybe with a little bit of the previous shade I've owned, which is Little Nude Coupe. That one is still my favorite, but the formulation on these, they're super long wearing. And even after the shine goes away, you still have a lot of color. They don't bleed on your lips. So I really love this formulation. I just wish they had a few more colors that weren't quite so bright. But if you're into bright lips and you want one that stays really well and is very moisturizing and comfortable, check out this line from Lipstick Queen. All right, last time I showed you an IT Cosmetics lip product that's very similar to this one from Tarte. This is the Maracuja Juicy Lip. Now the IT Cosmetics one, it just fell flat for me. It was a big dud. This one, I would say, I'm gonna put it in the darling category. I don't reach for this real often because it's not super long wearing, but I have to say that both the color and the formula, I mean, how it feels on the lips is, oh man, it feels like butter. It's very shiny, and you do have to be careful not to get too much, or it does tend to get a little goopy. But I found this one to actually help moisturize the lips a lot. And look at all of that color. I mean, there is a ton of color there. What color do I have? I have the shade Hibiscus. And so I do think it is a really nice formula, but I think because it is a little more slippery and it's not super long wearing, it's just not one I reach for much when I want kind of several hours of wear. But again, very comfortable. It's great for color, you know, something to throw on around the house and just make your lips feel and look beautiful. And I should mention, there is no scent on either of these lip products. Now I have two colors in this next lip product, and I feel like this has really just kind of flown under the radar. I really haven't heard anybody talking about these. These are from L'Oreal. Not sure exactly what the name of this formula is. I'll put it across the screen, but these are so interesting and they remind me of a product from Lancome that I absolutely love. And I have two shades here. I have 300 Be Uncontrollable and 317 Be Fiery. All right, what's so great about these? Well, these are the most interesting formulation. If you have tried the, I think it's the Lancome Lacquer, again, Absolute Lacquer, Lip Lacquer, something like that, I'll put it on the screen. If you have tried those, these I think are almost a dead-on dupe in formulation. So you put them on, they feel very cooling going on. You'll see there's a little bit of sheerness. Now, if you let it dry for just, I don't know, 10, 20 seconds, something like that, you can go back and add another layer and it deepens the color. So you can keep layering this. But what I love about this is the transfer resistance that these have is quite amazing. You're going to get a little bit of color transfer, but not much. The glossy part of it lasts for quite a bit, but it doesn't dry out your lips. I don't know, just a very interesting formulation, and I've actually really enjoyed them. Now, the one caveat is the color selection can be a little misleading. So I chose the colors based on what I saw here. And you really need to choose your colors based on what you see here. So this one is like fiery red, as the name says. But you can see it looks like a nice rosy pink in the tube. That's not the color it dries to be. So it's kind of like picking paint. If you pick paint from the wet paint color, you're probably going to be surprised at what color it is once it's dry. Now the other thing is the scent. There is a slight little bit of some perfumey-ish scent. It's not bad. It's not like the L'Oreal lipsticks in the Bullet, because I can't handle that. But there is a scent, so just be aware of that. I find that it does dissipate pretty quickly, but there you go. So that is that fiery shade. It's really pretty. I like this one kind of in one layer or so. As you layer it up, it can be a really fun bright shade, and again, stays put for a very long time, doesn't travel. So anyway, really great, unique formulation, and I'm putting it in the darling category. All right, and the final lip product is the Natasha Denona lipstick. This is in her nude lipstick line, but this is special limited edition packaging. This is the shade Amorosa. It's what I have on my lips today, paired with that lip liner, and I just love this. The smell is, I would say, more cake-like or cookies, maybe snickerdoodle cookies. Doesn't that sound good? The color is a really pretty kind of neutral nude shade. So it has a little bit of pink, a little bit of taupe on me. You can see, I mean, it's pretty neutral. I know sometimes shades like this look cooler on my skin tone than they do on somebody with cool skin tones. So you might have to maybe check out one of the other colors. But for me, this color, the formulation, everything, it's very long wearing. It's not goopy. It doesn't bleed. It's just really nice and definitely a darling. All right, now our final category is face products. And as I told you, I have a lot of face products, and I know I've been talking for quite a while, so let's just get moving. You might have to press pause, go get a cup of coffee, but come on back and let's get started now with some concealers. So recently, I've been testing out the Tarte Ultra Creamy Shape Tape Concealer. It's what I'm wearing today in combination with another one. All right, the good about this is it is not drying. I was one of those that could not use the original Shape Tape formula anymore because I just found it to be drying. No matter how little or how much I powdered or didn't powder, I could never get that one to not look dry under my eyes. This one, I feel like, stays moist. It's, you can just tell when you put it on, it is immediately more creamy. Now, on the flip side, this I was expecting to have the same coverage that Shape Tape has, and it does not. So if you were looking for full coverage in your concealer, this is not it. It says it is, but it is not. It would be, I would say, a good solid medium coverage. And I've tried to even build this up, but I still find that without some kind of color corrector or adding something else like I did today, the blue parts right here shine through. So I'm going to put this right in the mediocre category. It's not a flat out dud because I do feel like it's a very forgiving formula, but it's not an all out darling for me. The other concealer that I think I finally found the right color for me, so I found that I was ready to really review it, and it's the Milani Conceal and Perfect Concealer. So again, another one that I kind of struggle a little bit with because I find that this one on its own is a little bit too drying for me. So I have to be real careful, make sure I have a lot of moisture or pair it with a more hydrating concealer. But I do find this to have really good coverage. It's a nice thin formulation. So the color I finally found that I think works is medium beige. It is important to get the right color in your concealer if you go too light, which is what I had before. It just wasn't covering, but I do find it to have good coverage. But again, I'm just going to put this in the mediocre category. It's real hard for concealer to make it into the darling category for me because I expect a lot. Now, on to face. So let's start off with kind of base products. So I tried this one from Undone Beauty. This is brand new. I did see this brand in Target one time, and then Ulta is carrying almost their full line. I like the concept of this. So this is Conceal to Reveal Palette plus Glow Giving Coconut Extract 3-in-1 Coverage Cream. So this is three different formulations of the same shade. This top one, let me see if I can get this open. That's one of the issues. A little difficult to open. All right, so this top one is more sheer, but super hydrating. You can just see the glow there. Then we move down to kind of a little more pigmentation and not quite as hydrating, but still not real drying. And then we move down to the third little stripe here. And this one is the most pigmented. You can just feel the texture changes. I really love this concept. However, this one, you know, that was more hydrating, I put under my eyes and it's not enough coverage. So then I'm adding in another one of these and then it started to get a little cakey. And then by the time I got my whole face done, I just felt like this emphasized texture and pores, and it was not very long wearing. And I also had some breakouts from it. So just a big dud for me. However, one product that you saw me use, and so again, I'm not gonna go into too much detail, actually are these two from Wet n Wild. This is the Tinted Hydrator Tinted Skin Veil plus hyaluronic acid and squalane. This is an oil-free. It is a sheer tinted moisturizer. I've heard people give a review on this as a foundation and say it failed as a foundation. It's not a foundation. If you're looking for a foundation, this is definitely not it. But if you want just a sheer bit of coverage and just a nice bit of moisture and glow to your skin, again, I'll link that video up here where I use both of these products. I actually really like this, and as long as I powder my skin, I feel like I can get about a good 6 hours or so, maybe a little longer of wear time with this. So again, super sheer, and there is no sunscreen, but I was actually quite pleased with this, so it's a darling. Along with this Glass Correct Primer. This is a green-based primer. It's not super opaque though, so it's not gonna give you like opaque green correction on your face, but it just adds a little hint of a tint of green. So if you have redness in your skin, which I do, I used this before that tinted hydrator, but it gives your skin just a beautiful glow, but it's not oily. And as an oily skin girl, that's a really hard thing for us oily skin girls to find in a primer. But I found this to just make the skin look beautiful. So another win. Now the last kind of foundation type product, and I have not yet reviewed this. I don't even know if I've done a tutorial using it yet, but this is the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream. This became a staple from this to this. While we were moving, I had so many mornings where I had to rush out the door to meet contractors, painters, whatever. And I really found these two products to just really fill the need. So this Camo CC Cream from e.l.f., the first color I got was so wrong. I almost returned it for a refund, but I thought, you know what? I'm going to try a different color and see if that makes a difference. And holy cow, it was amazing because that light color just seemed to emphasize texture. And I also had tried it all on its own because I'm used to a CC cream being a one and done kind of product. This is not that. So I've heard this be compared to the IT Cosmetics CC cream. No, it's not. The only comparable might be that this has sunscreen, it has some good skin ingredients, and it has good coverage. But the IT Cosmetics CC cream has more full coverage. That's SPF 50. This is SPF 30. And the IT Cosmetics CC cream, I can actually put on without any moisturizer underneath. This one needs moisturizer. So as long as I added a little bit of moisturizer and then put this on, it was a beautiful finish. It lasted on me throughout the day. And I would say this is a good solid medium coverage. So I have been super impressed. The only thing that was a little surprising is the fact that this is $14. And I think we've all gotten used to e.l.f. products being like, you know, $1 to $3, $5, maybe $6. So when it came out, I was kind of set against it from the beginning because it was $14. But it does have a pump and the formula is good. So just look for a coupon on Ulta, use that, and I think it will be worth your money. Next, I just have one powder to share with you. It's from Danessa Myricks. And this is one product that's in the mediocre category. I have the shade 02. And while I do love the packaging, it has one of those mesh things and it also has a stopper. So it doesn't just fly all over the place. You could travel with it. I don't know. The formula doesn't wow me. I would say it helps set your makeup to a certain point, but I find that I get pretty shiny pretty quickly. It does have some blurring qualities when you initially apply it, but those blurring qualities I have not found to stay. My main hope with this one was to use it under the eyes because it's supposed to blur the fine lines and all that stuff. And I did use it today, and it's okay if I keep just a real minimum amount, but I do find that my under eyes do start to look a little dry throughout the day. So I just haven't found this to be anything different than a lot of the powders on the market. So I'm just gonna put this right in the mediocre category. And moving on to highlighters, I have four. Yes, four. All right, let's just go top down. All right, this is the RMS Beauty. This was a free sample from Sephora. And this is the Luminizing Powder. They've had kind of cream formula ones before, but I've really enjoyed this. Just a beautiful, smooth formulation. It does have a lot of shine, but there's no shimmer particles. It's what I'm wearing on the top portion of my cheek here. I've just really been impressed with that. Now, the other one that I am wearing a little lower down is this one by Buxom. So this is the Wanderlust Glow Highlighter in the shade White Russian. So they did a whole White Russian collection. I also have the eyeshadow face palette. Haven't gotten really dug into that one yet, but this highlighter. Okay, I swatched it and I was like, what's all the fuss about? I don't quite get it. Put it on the back of my hand and I'm like, well, I don't know. There is quite a bit of a pink shift, but it's not a holographic purpley pink shift. So that was good. And the formulation is really, again, very smooth. You don't see any glitter. But when I put this on my face, it's amazing. And I think the best way that I would say to use this is if you like to have more of a glowing blush, or if you have fine lines out here and you don't like to highlight the very top of your cheekbone, you want some highlighter, but it kind of goes more in this zone, I would say this is perfect because it's not going to white out your bronzer or your blush, but it's gonna add that little bit of glow there. And I don't know, it just, if it's placed in the right part of your face, it looks really natural and makes your cheeks just look healthy and glowy. Now the third highlighter, you've seen me use this a lot, so I'm not gonna talk too much about it, but this is from Jaclyn Cosmetics. This is the shade Iced. it's just beautiful. The packaging's beautiful. The formulation is super smooth. And holy moly, if you like a really strong highlighter, this line is for you. It does not take much. It will emphasize texture if you get too much product. So just go in with a light hand. But I have really been impressed with these. And again, the packaging is just gorgeous. Now, the last highlighter, I'm very sad to say, was another dud for me. This is the Danessa Myrix Dew Wet. And this is the shade Clear. All right. Again, I was so intrigued by this. It sounded just so unique and it looks amazing when you see the pictures. And even when you put this on your hand, it's like, it's clear. Now it does come in colors also, so you could do colors, but it's not the issue with the clear. So what it does is it just makes your skin look wet. So here's what I'll say about this. If you're somebody who does not wear foundation and you just want to add some glow to your face, if you like that kind of wet look on your skin, this is great. However, as you can see, do you see all that kind of makeup look right there? So it's a clear, it's clear with a silver pan. So that's what it should look like. But this makeup look here is because when you put this on top of makeup, it lifts off your foundation. So there's no way to apply this on top of foundation. Even I've tried it before powder, after powder, it will remove your foundation. And so it can start making it look patchy. I was so disappointed because again, like I said, on bare skin, it really does just make the skin look wet and glowy. But if you wear foundation and you want highlighter look, this is not the product for you. All right, we finally reached the final grouping and these are blush and bronzer products. All right, so first off, I ordered another shade of the Fenty Beauty Cream Blush. These are so tiny and cute, but there is quite a good amount of product. This is the shade Rose Latte. When I first looked at it and even swatched it, I was like, oh, that's a little more like reddish brown than I was hoping. But once I put it on my cheeks, it's actually the base color. I do have some things on top of it, but it's the base color of my cheek color today. And it's so pretty. It is definitely a rose latte color. So add a little bit of rosiness to your latte and that's what you're gonna get. These are long wearing, easy to work with, super easy. They just blend and melt right into the skin. Definitely a darling. Now the next cream blush you've also seen in a previous Get Ready With Me. This was by Milani. This is one of their Cheek Kiss blushes in Merlot Moment. Another darling in my book. These are also super easy to work with, even though this color looks quite pigmented. It blends out beautifully. I don't find that it really disturbs the makeup underneath. I used this with that Wet n Wild tinted hydrator and I found the two just worked wonderfully together. So again, one that blends out, melts into the skin, and yet lasts really well through the day. Now a combo of cream and powder blush. Again, if you see that Urban Decay Naked Wild West palette, you saw me use this. This is the Patrick Ta blush. What is this called? Double Take Cream and Powder Blush, and this is in the shade She's So LA. I've had one of these previously in another color, but this color, oh my word. It looks like it's just gonna be kind of a bronzer and who knows what, but this combination I have been loving. And the way you do this formulation is you're supposed to do the powder first, and then you top it with a little bit of the cream shade. Okay, now my swatches. Not pretty, but okay, this is the powder by itself, this is the cream by itself, and then this is the two combined. And I know it seems to just break all the rules to do powder and then cream on top, but somehow it works, and I just have really enjoyed this shade and this formulation. Now the last two are from Jaclyn Cosmetics again, and they are the Blush Bronzer Duo. So I have shown this one, and then I've since purchased another one in a deeper color. You're gonna freak out when you see it, but this shade is Sunkissed and Bronze Moment, I think, yes? Now this bronzer formulation is supposed to be matte, and then the blush is a glowy blush. But in swatching them and wearing them, I feel like this one has more of a satin finish. There's no shimmer or sparkle. Kind of reminds me of the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer, but this is what this particular duo looks like. So that is the bronzer. You can see it's a very soft, just more of a satin-like finish. And then the blush really doesn't have tons of glow. Like a pearl, maybe a little bit on that satin finish as well. And when I first swatched these, I thought, oh, there's not much pigmentation, but they build up very nicely on the cheeks and blend out beautifully. So I thought, hey, there's another color in the collection that looks beautiful. Let's try that one. Oh my goodness. So this is one of the deepest combos, and this is Be Rouge and Espresso Shot. So Be Rouge, Espresso Shot. Now, keep in mind, these are not contour shades unless you're super deep skin tone, but even then, this does have quite a lot of red in it. And the bronzer, typically I don't use that as my contour. So, but I have loved both of these more as blushes. Now these are, oh my goodness, pigmentation. Like you have to tap your brush off or you're gonna get too much on your cheeks. All right, so you can see from these swatches, they are quite pigmented, but I have actually been enjoying this one, the Espresso Shot, more as a kind of blush topper, blush color, kind of mixing in my bronzer and my blush. So I have that actually on the back portion of my cheeks, just real lightly. Gotta tap your brush off on a tissue first for these shades if you're fairer skin tone like I am. But the formulation is beautiful. I have just really found these to be very forgiving. And again, if you're not going for a super deep shade on fair skin tone, you can really go in and just build these up. They do build up nicely, and it's not too much pigmentation all at once in these lighter shades. So this is actually the combo that I also have on my cheeks. And the formulation, the packaging, definitely darlings. All right, we did it. We got through all of those products. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure you give it a thumbs up. For next month, I am hoping to be down to just 1 month's worth of product. As life is starting to settle down to more of a normal pace, I'm hoping to get more on a regular filming schedule. So if you are new here, be sure you hit that subscribe button before you leave, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.